This is Windows XP Aero 2, the sequel to the famous mod Windows XP Aero, and as an alternate scenario, if Windows XP is still the faithful base for future Windows version. Looking at the desktop, it looks more like Windows XP than Windows 7. The desktop background looks like a longhorn-like variant of Bliss. The taskbar explicitly looks like XP with something modifications, but the icon looks like Windows 7. How? Well, let's take a look at the setup first. The Windows Boot Manager looks exactly like Windows 7 because, well, it is taken from Windows 7. Even though the text mode setup is still in place, the boot screen is shown, and it's a different variant. Moving to the graphical setup, this new design appears in the graphical setup too. It's exactly a blend of XP's layout with Windows 7 design. I like it. When the setup is finished, the prompt to restart looks like a normal Windows 7 dialog window. The please wait part of the setup is designed to resemble the Windows 7's setup is preparing Windows for first use. Man, I wish the loading bar from Windows 7 exists here, but no worries, here comes the OOBE intro video. The OOBE still feels like Windows XP, but the design is changing to look like Windows 7. Rebooting the OS, the login screen has a unique style. The time and date at the upper right corner of the screen is based on an early Longhorn build. This is also appears in the original XP Aero. Now, back again at the desktop, taking a look at the start menu, the layout has been, well, slightly simplified. Comparing to the XP Aero, as the shortcuts to Internet Explorer and Windows Media Player were removed. Oh yeah, also the icon changes. The application list is still bearing the Windows XP version, but that's no worries for me. Moving on to the Windows Explorer, the design is trying to resemble the Windows 7 version, or well, mixing it with Windows XP layout. Look at the task pane. It uses Secure UI, the Windows 7 button design, as well as simplified look with no border in it. Nice detail. But what is nicer is the breadcrumb, which is also found in XP Aero, but this version feels little simpler. Another detail that I noticed is that the messages design when entering several system folders has been changed. I definitely low-key like it. Oh yeah, another thing that I want to mention is that the window layout, it still uses the Windows XP layout, of course, but the caption box has been revamped to have Windows 7 design in it. You can see the similarities between them if you have the Windows 7 basic theme. Alright, for basic Windows applications, the quantity of them, as it is famously known of, have gotten good changes. Calculator now uses the newer version found in Windows 7 beta build, specifically build 6498. It has a unique look, featuring the latest calculation at the top and current calculation at the bottom. Paint is using the Windows 7 version, although the quick access toolbar is located below the ribbon, for some reason. WordPad also got its newer version. Although you only have Calibri as the font option and you can't change it as far as I tried, and it is supposed to have OTT and DocX document support, but I tried it and, well, it doesn't show up anything. And Notepad is just being Notepad. Checking out other system applications, some of them are modified from Windows XP Aero, and some of them are taken from Windows 7. Internet Explorer is version 8, which is officially supported in Windows XP Service Pack 2 and 3. Windows PowerShell from Windows 7 is available in here for advanced command line interpreter. It only runs as an administrator by default. And of course, you know it, Command Prompt. It even lists out that this is Windows build 7601, which is the build number for Windows 7 Service Pack 1. Snipping Tool retains its version. Windows Media Player is still version 11 that was bundled in Vista, but it is customized to look as faithful as possible to version 12. Gosh, I miss the visualization on music players. And just to make sure it's the correct version, this is the about dialogue. Windows Easy Transfer from Windows 7 is included in here with limited capability as it only able to export data or transfer data as an old computer. Windows Search from XP Era 2 is still in here, although Roved Dog is now removed. And there are heaps more such as Windows Defender, Windows Security Center, Windows Firewall, XPS Viewer, Font Viewer, Sound Recorder, Remote Desktop Connections, Windows Journal, and even Windows Media Center is in here. Amazing! Even though all those applications are from XP Era or Windows 7, several applications still use its former variants from XP, such as Task Manager, Magnifier, which I don't know which version is this from, tell me in the comments if you know, On-Screen Keyboard, and Address Book, which is invisible in the Start menu, but still accessible manually via Windows Explorer. Opening a bunch of applications at once, you can see that the OTAP interface is actually the same one as in Windows XP Aero, although it has Windows 7 color design or, well, whatever you want to call it. We have seen the applications. What about customizations? Well, looking at the control panel, it has the Windows 7 design combined with Windows XP, which makes it better. Heck, the category view is really suiting the UI. And using the classic view, icons are changed to the Windows 7 version. Okay, well, what about control panel applets? Well, here it is. First, the personalization applet is borrowing the same applet from Windows Vista. Themes are all available in here. Not just that, you can change the in-code Aero Windows scheme to different color. Even though the time it takes to change between each one is, well, quite long. I don't know if this is because the emulation or just my skill issue in general. Screensavers are provided in here. Sound schemes are following Windows 7 naming, and they are pretty cool. Take a listen. Going back to control panel, there are several additional applets such as Clear Type Tuning, which is available in Windows 7 too, Device Manager and Default Programs, which are tucked in several steps as it was in Windows XP, are added in here the main control panel view as an easier way to access it. And the last one, Backup and Restore. Feeling a bit lonely with the OS? Well, Sample Media is here for you. We got several sample music sounds and sample images. Sample Media doesn't suit you? Well, there are games in here, such as There are games in here such as Chess Titans. Internet games are provided in here if you want to play a certain game online with your friend. But these don't work anymore and they are for decorative purposes only. You might have noticed along the way that sidebar is not on a screen, just like the subscribe button, which is actually at the bottom of the screen. Okay, anyway, the sidebar does actually still exist, albeit not running by default. You have to go to the Start menu to run it, and then you can set it up afterwards. It still uses the same foundation as Windows Vista, which provides gadgets bar at the right. Alright, I have one specific detail that I want to share. Dism, an imaging tool from Windows Vista onward, is in here. This tool is crucial in Windows installation as well as several modding scenarios. Just to remind you now that it is Windows XP if you have goldfish memory, because, well, look at the WinVer. It's the Windows 7 logo wordmark plastered with XP. And in system properties, the listed version in it is version 2009. Thanks to Aurorarian as the creator, as well as other people listed in the credits here, this mod is a pretty solid sequel to XP Aero, as I want to say it. But there are still things that I need to question a little bit. Well, there are several applications and services missing, such as Game Explorer, 3D Pinball, Fax and Scan, Getting Started, Experience Index, AeroPeak, Snap and Shake, Home Group, Math and Input Panel, and Accessibility Wizard. But maybe the extras pack is the answer for all these missing things. After it has been installed, we can see that there are many additional goodies for the mod. Windows Movie Maker is one of them, which does make sense since Windows 7 doesn't have that by default, at least the ultimate version. Additional games like Hold'em, Inkball, Reversey, Tinker, and 3D Pinball. Classic WordPad and Paint from Build 6730 are installed for a little fun on ya. Accessibility Wizard is in here, finally! As for appearance customization, let's just say there are too many of them in my opinion, such as new Windows Media Player skins, user account pictures, sample media, cursor themes, wallpapers, screensavers, visual styles, and sound scheme. Oh boy, there are so many that you can customize it all day. And not just that, there are still several things not installed by the pack, but included in the ISO, such as gadgets, Live Messenger, .NET Framework, XNA Framework, Power Toys, Live Essential, and Media Player Plus. Gosh, that sounds like a streaming service. But anyway, the extras pack does answer several questions for me. Apart from that, you can check out this mod and try it for yourself. But for me, I can't wait for the next version of this, which is Windows XP Metro. So yeah, I really can't wait for that. Also, because of just how...